J.K. Rowling's life is an impressive rags-to-riches story. She went from struggling as a single mother, living on government assistance, and dealing with a dozen rejections from book publishers, to finding her road to success and becoming one of the most well-known authors of all time. And most importantly, she gave us the magical world of Harry Potter. Joanne Rowling grew up along the border of England and Wales with her mother, father, and sister. As a child, Jo Rowling, as she calls herself, grew up surrounded by books and knew that all she wanted to do was write. She would often write fantasy stories and read them to her sister. She wrote her first book, A Story About a Rabbit, when she was only 6. A couple years later, she and her family moved near the Forest of Dean, which later influenced Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. Soon, at age 11, she wrote her first novel, one about 7 cursed diamonds and the people who owned them. But when J.K. was only 15, her mother was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. Her life at home was suddenly complicated by her mother's diagnosis, causing many problems within her family and leaving J.K. with some pretty unhappy teenage years. J.K. was soon off to college. After being rejected from Oxford University, she earned her degree in French and Classics from the University of Exeter in the UK. She lived in Paris for a year as part of the program and fell in love with the city. After graduating college, she moved to London, where she got a job as a secretary. But she was pretty disorganized and often found herself scribbling her ideas for her next story. Even though J.K. Rowling had been writing her entire life, it wasn't until she was 25 years old that she finally found the right thing to write about. One day, while she was on a 4-hour delayed train trip from Manchester to London, a story idea about a young boy that didn't know that he was a wizard that would go to wizarding school came fully formed into her mind. Her mind was flowing with all these ideas about the Hogwarts wizarding school, and the 4 houses there would be, and the friends, Hermione Granger and Ron Weasley that Harry would go on adventures with, and what subjects they were going to teach, who the headmaster was. She had never felt more excited in her life, and she knew that was the thing she was destined to write. A few months later, her mother passed away after suffering from multiple sclerosis for 10 years. Her mother's death sent the 25-year-old Rowling into an emotional tailspin. She had never told her mother about her new book idea, and that's something that she regrets even to this day. J.K. started using her pain and channeled her own feelings into Harry's feelings of loss, making them have even more detail than before. J.K. Rowling was desperate to escape her pain. She took all of her notes and moved to Portugal after seeing an ad for a teaching position. She taught English at night and began writing during the day. She later married television journalist Jorge Arantes and soon gave birth to her first daughter, Jessica. But the marriage was unhealthy, and it ended shortly after. Rowling packed up her daughter in a suitcase containing the first 3 chapters of what would later become Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone and returned to the UK to live near her sister in Edinburgh. Rowling saw herself as a failure. She was jobless, with a dependent child and a failed marriage. She was diagnosed with clinical depression and was struggling as a single mother trying to survive on government welfare. J.K. was as poor as it was possible to be in modern Britain without being homeless. But Rowling had a daughter she adored, an old typewriter, and a big idea. And for her, that was enough. She saw her failure as an opportunity to direct all her energy into finishing her book. Hitting rock bottom became the foundation on which she began to rebuild her life. Over the next years, Rowling began to create an entire magical world of wizards and witches while mapping out all of the 7 books of the Harry Potter series. She wrote in many cafes, as tiny Jessica slept by her side. The time came when J.K. Rowling had finally finished her manuscript for Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. She went to 12 different publishers, all of which rejected her book. But Rowling didn't give up. 13 turned out to be a lucky number for her, and her book was finally published in the UK by Bloomsbury in June 1997. The decision to publish Rowling's book was mainly due to the 8-year-old daughter of Bloomsbury's chairman, who was given the first chapter to read by her father and instantly fell in love with Harry Potter. The book was published under Rowling's pen name, J.K. Rowling. Her publishers asked her to use 2 initials instead of her name, since she was a female author, and they thought that the target audience of young boys wouldn't want to read a book written by a woman. J.K. didn't have a middle name, so she chose her favorite grandmother's name, Kathleen, and used the initial K as her middle name. Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone had an initial print run of only 1,000 copies, with 500 of those distributed to libraries. But the book was a hit, and Rowling soon won her first award as an author, followed by multiple other awards. Soon, publishers in the US were anxious to publish her book. An auction was held for the rights to publish the novel, with Scholastic winning, and soon publishing the book with a different title in the US, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. With the earnings from the auction, J.K. Rowling was finally able to buy her own apartment. Harry Potter became a global sensation. The pressure became overwhelming at times for her. Never in a million years did she think her book would be so successful. During her second tour in the US, she saw a huge line of people as she was driving to the event that went on for blocks, and it was all for her. She signed 2,000 books, and the line still hadn't ended. It was at that moment that J.K. knew it was getting crazy. A year later, her second book, Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, was published, followed by her third and fourth books, each about a year apart. Warner Brothers was soon purchasing the film rights for the first two books, followed by all the others. J.K. always supported charities. But now that she had enough money, she decided to launch her own charities to combat poverty and social inequality. She also contributes a great amount of money for the research and treatment of multiple sclerosis, from which her mother suffered and died from. After her fourth book, Rowling kept writing. She published two short books in 2001, Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, and Quidditch Through the Ages. All the profits from the two books went to charity. That same year, the film adaptation of the first Harry Potter book was released by Warner Brothers, and J.K. Rowling received the Order of the British Empire from the Prince of Wales for her services to children's literature. Rowling had already risen to fame with her famous books when she met and married her second husband, Dr. Neil Murray. Soon after, in the midst of writing the fifth Harry Potter book, her son, David, was born. During David's early infancy, J.K. ceased working for a while on her novel to care for him. Shortly after, her fifth and longest book, Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix, was published. Forbes named Rowling the first person to become a billionaire by writing books, and as the second richest female entertainer. However, Rowling disputed Forbes' calculations and said that although she had plenty of money, she was not a billionaire. J.K.'s third and youngest child, Mackenzie, was born 6 months before the release of her sixth book, Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. The final book, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, was released in July 2007. The book sold 11 million copies in its first day, making it the fastest-selling book of all time. The book's last chapter was one of the first things J.K. Rowling wrote in the whole series. In 2011, Warner Bros. Released the final movie of the Harry Potter series, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2. J.K. had long promised an encyclopedia that would go over everything from the Wizarding World, so she launched her digital company, Pottermore. This new website gave the Harry Potter fans a chance to get sorted into their house, take quizzes, and read bits of information about the Harry Potter universe. Also, Rowling published her first novel for adults, The Casual Vacancy, which was later turned into a television drama miniseries. The next year, J.K. started writing crime novels under the pseudonym Robert Galbraith. Their first book, The Cuckoo's Calling, was published, and for a while, nobody knew the true identity behind the new author. A total of four books from the series have since been published, with the fifth one on its way. She also made her screenwriting debut when Warner Brothers extended her contract to produce the movie Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. After J.K. Rowling started collaborating with famous playwrights, the play Harry Potter and the Cursed Child opened in London. The book was released shortly after. Rowling's newest book, The Ichabod, was published online for free, with the print version of the book being scheduled for the future. In just a few years, J.K. Rowling went from living on welfare and feeling a failure to publishing her groundbreaking book and on her way to building her own empire. More than 500 million Harry Potter books have been sold all over the world. She is now known throughout the world because of her books, movies, merchandise, a play, and even the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, an area in Universal Studios in different parts of the world. As J.K. Rowling famously said during the commencement speech at Harvard University, "It is impossible to live without failing at something, unless you live so cautiously that you might as well not have lived at all."